Hey everyone, welcome back to the workshop. Of course, we have to do a bonus video for Halloween. I can't help myself, I love Halloween. We just did the Undertaker dragster for Saturday's full build. Today's bonus video on Halloween will be VRC Hobbies, the Phantom of the Opera in 1/8 scale. Yes, the old Aurora style kit, the Aurora style boxing. What's special about this is VRC is a hobby shop on eBay. They contacted the channel and said, we had a kit produced for us by Atlantis Toy and Hobby, made in the USA, molded in USA, molded in metallic green. It is a collector's kit. You can also, of course, build it up and paint it as the standard Phantom of the Opera model. But what's special about it is it's a limited edition and the entire kit is molded in a cool metallic green. We got the old style packaging in there. Comes out this year, 2022. It is pretty awesome. And then there's a paint guide on the side if you choose to paint the model up as a regular old model. But what I'm going to do for this bonus video is I'm just going to build the model as it is. Just going to put it together and display it in that cool metallic green to show you what's available. I will link down in the description at the VRC website. You can get this kit at a great price and free shipping. First, we got the old style instruction manual. I love these. They tell a story all in their own. The illustrators just must have really enjoyed putting these together back in the day and making them on there. But you'll assemble the whole base and go through it. You'll assemble the Phantom. And then on the back, it tells you how to put everything together. The base, the display. These always make such a cool diorama. Let's look at the plastic parts in the kit. We'll just start getting them out. It is a gorgeous metallic green. I would love to see this for some model cars. That is very, very cool. It's a nice shade. We got excellent detail on these molds. I mean, nice seams and everything for the clothing. I own one of the prior Phantom of the Opera releases, so I know it's a great kit, but I would never want to paint this one. It's special edition, metallic green from the folks at VRC Hobbies. That is so awesome. We got some loose parts in the bag. Check out the wall. I love when I paint these and I can weather them and run grime down them and all that. Because just look at all the detail on there. Look at the Phantom's face. Now, that is pretty accurate. I mean, that's a beautiful molding, in my opinion. So, and back in the day, someone had to carve this out and then carve it out of metal to make the mold. Look at the hand. Veins in the hand, fingernails. Really, really nice. We'll see how it all fits up. I'm sure these older kits need some filler or some super glue. We got the other hand there. We got some rocks for the base. So you can do a lot of cool weathering. And I checked it and inflation hasn't kicked this model. It is still at a good price, at a standard issue price with free shipping. I will link that in the description, like I said. This is the chamber underneath him. Like in the picture, it's above him. In the diorama, we want to focus on the Phantom, so it ends up being underneath his feet. So we've got that there. What else we got going on? We got the cape. Huge piece of styrene. I love the smell of new plastic. And this one's got a really good smell, too, because it must be something with the metallics in it. Look at the chest of the vest. Chest of the vest. Superb detailing and molding, and that green really brings it out too. That's what I'm excited about. I will do some cleaning up of some flash and stuff, like in the tails of his tux here. Look at the guy holding the bars. Please, please let me out. I'm starving. Oh man, they even molded it like he's starving. It's all skinny, rotted, cut open, and tortured. Yeah, go back to the nice looking tux instead. We've got a rat here. Rat Fink. We've got maybe a rope or something here. We got, I don't know, something, a thumb. Got a tie. We got a little loose rat, a little baby one. So that one looks pretty cool. We've got the prisoner suffering. Whoa, look at that. Oh, that is just so cool looking. And that green is going to stand out so awesome for Halloween. And then finally on this tree, we've got the diorama base in that eighth scale. Looks wonderful. Phantom of the Opera carved out on the front. Got our locating areas. I'm just going to break that off. And then we've got the mask and his shoes. Yes, so that is awesome. I mean, I think that is a really nice representation of Lon. I think that's a nice one. So I'm going to get to gluing this together. That's what we're going to do on camera, and I'll be right back. So what you saw was I glued it all together pretty trouble-free. I did not touch up a seam on this thing. So what you see is what you will get. Now, of course, you could go and touch up some of these seams, but the fit, usually legs on a kit are really hard to get. So Atlantis must have cleaned up these molds or worked on them, or back in the Aurora days, this thing just fit perfectly as is. Because honestly, where this thing has seams would be seams on real clothing. You can see the crotch seam in there looks great, even underneath. I mean, nothing to worry about. We got that cravat or whatever, the bow tie. We got the mask in there, the hands, the little thumb, that's what that piece was. Lon Chaney's face looks awesome. Got the cape on there. That little thing is the chain for the cape. I mean, it is beautiful. Let me subdue the lighting in the shop a little bit here. There we go. Get some backlighting so you can actually see the figure better in that green. There you go. Look at that. And I love that green. It's even got its own shadows. Just the way it is. And then we've got the base, which is a piece of art in itself. We've got the prisoner back there, please free me. With his awesome hands clamping the bars. We got the two rats, or a rat and a mouse. We got the rocks. This thing, painting this would be a pleasure. But I'm just going to put it together. We've got that peg on the foot. That's why you saw me line the legs up, so I could make sure that they were touching the base properly. But that long peg, and they do give you an extra big space to fit that in so you can make your adjustments. So we'll get that in there like so. I'll glue it together, and then I will give the entire model a coat of future floor polish to even out everything and make that green really shine. I'll brush that on and let that dry for an hour. So I'm going to attach these two with some super glue. We'll put those together for the final assembly, and you'll be able to see what Lon will look like here when we get them all together. And then I will have them on the turntable so we can see it all the way around in just a second. As you can see, from the base to the top of the mask, this is a great size statue. It's in the 1/8 scale. It's easy to assemble. It hardly has any seams worth worrying about. I personally think that Lon Chaney looks great in that mold. We're going to look at the size of this thing. If I turn it the right way, we're looking at 9 3/4 inches from the bottom to the top. That is a nice size model. You don't see a lot of kits that big, and it's a beautiful looking model. The green that it's molded in gives it this cool look. I clear coated it with the future, and now it's all super shiny and metallic. It is fitting looking. I mean, look how the seams disappear. So if you were to paint this thing up and you didn't want to waste a lot of time, some of these figure kits, you know, the old MPC kits and stuff like that from Star Wars, some of those figure kits can really be a pain, but this thing is really nicely done. Someone spent time making sure that those molds fit together properly and did some pre-assembly. Even the back, which rarely would be seen, fits nicely. The rocks to the base, the rats, they're half and half. They fit nice. I mean, it's a really, really great kit. I can't say enough good things about it. I want to thank VRC Hobbies for sending this over. I want to wish all of you a happy Halloween. If you want to make your Halloween a little bit happier, I will link in the description on eBay where you can pick this up direct from VRC Hobbies, and the auction currently says free shipping, so you don't even have to pay for that. Wonderful kit, as you saw, built it pretty much in real time, and it goes together so easy. So again, thanks to you for watching. Happy Halloween. Remember, on Halloween, candy calories do not count, so eat as much as you want, have some fun, build your models your way. If you love the monster kits, pick up this Phantom of the Opera in the limited edition metallic green and enjoy your hobby. We will see all of you at the next review.